Records show that many people are losing their lives and body parts as a result of high rate of accidents and diseases like diabetes and cancer. According to the Minister for Works and Transport, General Edward Katumba Wamala, there is a need for government to train orthopedics in Uganda.
It would be good for the minister and government to renovate this structure so that at least the working environment and even the environment where the patients come is much better, because with the machinery here and the putting up, refurbishing this structure should not be a very big issue. So I think that's where we should go. And I'll also bring it up to my friend, the Minister of Health, and even in cabinet, that we can put our resources together with what they have done so that we have this facility, a better facility.
The minister was visiting limb beneficiaries at Mulago Hospital who are being treated courtesy of the Indian Women Association of Uganda and the Indian High Commission. Katumba says this intervention is timely and requested the High Commission to train Ugandan doctors to carry out such services in Uganda.
Two of the observations which I made in my speech was about the negative effects of the accident, where people lose limbs, where people lose their lives. Even if somebody doesn't lose their life and loses his limb, the life totally changes. For example, somebody has lost both legs. That person becomes incapacitated, and if he's the breadwinner of the family, that family's life is totally changes.
Suman Van Ketch, the chairperson Indian Women Association of Uganda, says that they are to work on 600 people to get artificial limbs, and so far 280 have been worked on since the campaign started a few weeks ago.
This is an initiative taken by Government of India, and they've been doing this all over the world. So they plan to have it in Uganda too. So we, as a local partner, we are helping the Ugandans here.
Andrew Sebira, compiled this.